The majority of the drinks that we've made so far have been pretty universal and female oriented. So this next drink is for you guys out there. And this is called the Outlaw. Now this is our original recipe. This isn't something that you can walk into a bar and order. So don't try to walk into a bar and say, hey, can I get the Outlaw? You're gonna look like an idiot. So this drink, the reason I think it's manly is because it's the only drink on our menu that has Scotch whiskey, essentially, as its main source of alcohol. So let's get started.
Wait, before that, what's the difference between Scotch and whiskey?
Well, Scotch is a whiskey.
So a lot of people don't know this, but Scotch is actually just a whiskey that's made in Scotland.
Wow, the more you know.
All right, so we're gonna start off with 2 ounces of blended Scotch. And the reason I use blended Scotch is because blended Scotch is cheaper than a single malt. A single malt is usually drank either neat or on the rocks, whereas a blended Scotch, it's less expensive, so it goes better with a mixed drink because you don't need the expensive stuff in these mixed drinks. It's not necessary. The next ingredient is gonna be 1/2 ounce of lemon juice. So let's get our citrus squeezer. We need 1/2 ounce lemon juice.
Did you roll it?
No.
That's why you can't squeeze the juice out. You know what, this is a really good example.
That's good, you know, that's true.
It usually
is a lot easier to squeeze out the lemon, but because I forgot to roll it, that's why I'm having such difficulty here. So keep in mind, before you try to squeeze your fruits, always roll it. Toss that in there. Next ingredient is gonna be 1/2 ounce of grapefruit juice. Now, I like the taste of grapefruit, personally, so I actually add in 3/4 ounce. I mean, try it out, see if you like it. If you don't, just stick to the recipe of 1/2 ounce. And then we're gonna have 3/4 ounce of simple syrup. And keep in mind, you don't wanna go to where you think 3/4 of this jigger is. You want 3/4 of the actual serving size. And lastly, we're going to put a couple dashes of bitters. Bitters are actually alcohol that are mixed with plant extract, and it has a very distinct flavor, so it adds some complexity to the drink. Next, you're gonna add some ice. Take the contents, mix it up. All right, so this is another drink that we're gonna need the pre-chilled martini glass for. Thank you. Grab your strainer. All right, so this next part of the drink is the most exciting part of this drink. This is what's gonna make the girl fall in love with you. So this is called a flaming orange twist. And this is probably something that the girl has never seen before in her life. What you're gonna be doing is you're gonna take this orange peel, you're gonna cut about 2 to 3 inches off of just the peel, not the orange itself. You don't want any part of the orange to be in the peel. It tends to mess up when you create the fire. So you can take a match, or lighter, it works either way. And you're gonna squeeze the oils from this peel onto this fire, like so. So what it does is it actually releases the oils from the orange peel, and you take this orange peel and rim the glass so that not only will it have the aroma of the orange, so when they drink it, they'll have the aroma, but you slip this slice in. You always have to slip it in the peel side up, otherwise it's just gonna look like trash, so that they get the flavor of the orange as well. If a girl comes over and asks me to make her a drink with whiskey, this is the cocktail that I make for her. And then I propose, because any girl that comes over and asks for a drink made with whiskey is marriage material. So this right here is to my future wife. You guys wanna try it out?
Kong, future husband.
How delicious is that?
Future husband as well.
That is really good.
Yeah.
That is like seriously too good.
Just down it.
This is better
I still gotta make, will I be able to make more drinks if I down this? I don't know.
Well, I mean, the only way to find out is by doing it, right?
I would say this tastes better than your mom's butthole. For sure.
I just didn't expect that. All right, so the Outlaw.